Lewis Reed says St. Louis needs to make a big change in the way it fights violent crime, but that comes with a big price tag of $8 million. He believes a program called Cure Violence is the answer. He's introduced legislation in the Board of Aldermen to spend $8 million to fund that program for 3 years.
Why $8 million for Cure Violence? Isn't that an awful lot of money to gamble?
No, that's not a lot of money at all. You look at, you know, the number of crime, number of murders we've had in our city. I don't think if you talk to any of the parents that have lost children or anybody that's lost a loved one or a friend, you know, whether $8 million is justifiable or not.
Cure Violence has been used in a lot of cities across the country. The big question, can it work here?
You can't guarantee this is going to work.
We're
going to gamble $8 million.
Here's what I'd say. If we don't do it, we know what we're going to get.
But some officials I talked to have their doubts about this deal. Cure Violence treats crime as a disease. Essentially, it goes into problem areas, identifies the problem people, and tries to find resolutions for their issues causing them to turn to crime. I talked to a high-ranking St. Louis official who says there's no guarantee it'll work here. First, they say, for it to be effective, all city officials need to be on the same page. That's not the case here in St. Louis. The official says the local police department needs to be operating at peak efficiency so you can have a stick to go along with the carrot. Also, not the case in St. Louis, where the police department is short about 150 officers. Then they say there's the price tag. One top St. Louis official told me Chicago spent tens of millions of dollars over 4 years on the program. Some are questioning the results. Lewis Reed trying to get the St. Louis Board of Aldermen to okay $8 million here. Here's Alderwoman Carol Howard.
We need to use everything in our power to fight crime, but just willy-nilly, you know, spending $8 million without doing our research. I'm not a fan because they don't often work. You know, it's one size fits all.
You got some people on your own Board of Aldermen that say, bad deal, questionable deal. We don't know about spending $8 million bucks on this. How do you answer?
You know, look. The plans that we're pushing are aggressive, and they're aggressive for a reason, right? To change the dynamics of what's happening in these streets, like even the violent weekend we just went through. If people are willing to continue that, let's just keep doing the same thing.
What are your thoughts about $8 million for Cure Violence?
Well, I think that's a little bit too much.
Aldermen aren't the only ones with doubts about this deal. The Cruz administration is for trying out a pilot program to see if it works, and then they can add more if they get good results. The mayor not on board with $8 million bucks. She's not alone.
I believe in the program. I believe we should try it, but I don't believe $8 million. That's a lot.
We will continue to be one of the most dangerous cities in America if we do not push for some data-driven plan that has been proven to work in city after city after city after city.
Reed says, despite some opposition, he's confident he can get the Board of Aldermen to go along with $8 million plan. He'll also need to convince the E&A board he sits on with the mayor and the comptroller. We'll let you know what happens to the plan that changed the way we fight crime in St. Louis. After all, you paid for it.